Hello everybody, this is your host Kyoko Hoshi, and we are going to be doing some more stuff today on Creatures of Sonaria. So, the new creature is out, cannot say its name probably, but I have the new creature. We're going to do the showcase on it, and I guess like before going into a small explanation of getting this creature, because it is a secret mission creature, and you're going to need to have bleed inflicted upon you in order to get this creature. I believe, was it for me? I was pretty much counting. I had it on like a calculator. I think I had a mag attacking me, and they did like about 30. So they did 30. I sat down and healed it off, and then did it again until it reached 30. So I did that a couple of times, and I think it took, I think it got about 240 from what I was counting. I got up to 240, and I had, after I got done healing it off, I had gotten the unlocked the creature. But I either 240, 250 plus, you have to heal that much off of you, basically. So you get hit with some bleed. So if you get hit with like bleed that gives you just like 7, then basically you're going to be adding up 7. Until it gets to like 240 plus, 250, 240, 250 plus, and then you should be able to unlock the creature. So that's how I got mine. That's how you get the creature, is just you have to heal from bleed damage. Let it get to the max, heal it off, keep doing it, just keep doing that until you see at the side, it'll show you. You got it. So then in the gacha, you can, where is it? Was it Omni? Omni, yeah. It's an Omni, so here it is. It's a 6.25% drop rate in the Omnivore section, and then it is a 11.1% drop rate in the Bleeder section. This one is a little bit more expensive. I see 350 in order to, you know, have a try to get it, other than possibly getting one of the other creatures that are Bleeders. And the Omnivore one is 85, so I would probably go towards the Omnivore one versus wanting to, you know, spend so much and probably not get it with the Bleeder one. So there's your options for that, depending on, you know, how much you have. But we have the creature, and we're going to go ahead and do a showcase on it. Let's see. Let's go find this bad boy. Sometimes I always can never find things whenever I need to. Oh, there you are. Zethines. I'm not sure if that's how you say it, like always, but I'll at least show you, at least for the ability part, and we'll do the rest of this on the other half. Actually, probably because I'm doing them right now, but creature abilities. It has bleed defense is 40%, but this creature does also do bleed. That's probably why for the secret mission, you have to inflict bleed upon someone, because the creature itself does bleed. It took a minute to get this, actually. It took a pretty good minute, because I was sitting there with one of my friends, and we were trying to figure it out. We kept attacking, healing, attacking, but it was taking a long time. Sadly, my friend had to go. But eventually, I just sat there and was like, okay, let's figure this out. But got it eventually, but it took a minute. So, before we can go in, this creature is a tier 4. But this creature actually has a very short growth rate for a tier 4, which is 16 minutes. That is very short for a tier 4. Here we are with them in full view, looking as adorable. They will probably look so beautiful as a glimmer. I don't know what parts, I'm not sure if it would be these parts right here would be the glimmer. I don't know, but either way, this one looks so gorgeous as a glimmer, I think. Hope to get one as a glimmer for this one. It's gonna look so gorgeous. Let's see if they have any difference. Oh, actually, they don't have too many spots for them to color. And we have a very, very blue color palette for this creature. No second color palette, but we have a very blue one. Any difference? I don't think there's any. Actually, I don't think there's any difference between male and female with this one. Oh, all right. So there's no difference between male and female for this specific creature. Like, good lord, look at them. Look at them toenails. Oof, get cut by those. You're done. Oh, this creature looks so cool. I think they said it was based off, like, the front part right here. T-pose it. The front part right here is based off of, you know, ground sloth. So it has a big old digging claws right there. Do not get smacked with those, because you ain't going to survive. But let's go ahead and get into the showcase. Well, yeah, let's get into the showcase, guys. Well, we spawned in and tornado. It's always my luck when with a tornado, and whenever I get in the game, it's always my luck having a tornado. Oh my gosh. Okay, it is daytime. We have a little bit before we're grown up, but here's the baby. So let's go ahead and look at the stats for this creature. So their base health stat is 3,400, max stamina 100, speed. Let's see, their speed would actually, their walk is 20, but their run is 68. Let's see what else. Their damage is 180, so that's pretty good for it. And their bleed is 7. So this is a pretty decent, pretty decent bleed for this creature. Their night vision is a 1, so cannot see at night. And of course, they are tier 4. And they also are an omnivore. Oh, and another thing about the secret mission, not sure if this is the one of the requirements. I think you also have to be a herbivore receiving the bleed. So you can't be like a carnivore or other ones. You have to be you can't be a carnivore. I think you have to be a herbivore. I think that might also contribute with you getting the creature. So give that a shot, guys. And hopefully y'all guys will be able to get the creature just by being herbivore, getting hit with bleed, and having a total of 240 plus or 250 plus for that. And make sure you guys heal. Don't just let people hit you, and don't say stop. Like, say stop. But I'll be back when we turn into a teenager. Oh yeah, and their weight is 4,500 in the grounded, so no swimming for this creature either. And now look at us as a grown teenager. Oh, they look so gorgeous. Definitely when they turn into old adult, them freaking arm spikes get pretty gosh darn ridiculous, but they do look really cool. They have, what, look like three eyeballs? I like their little face. Look at the little face. That's what it makes. I don't know why it's, that's what, because it has like little over lip, just meh. But we'll be back once we are a full grown adult. So we're an adult, but I just wanted to show you guys like what, this is what it looks like at night. So this is what you see with one vision at night with this this character, this creature right here. Okay, I'll see you back when it's daytime. It is now daytime, and this is what a full grown adult looks like. You're so freaking amazing. I still do. Not touching these big old shoulder blades. Nor am I touching that giant toe claw, the big old hand claws. Not even this tail. Not touching it. But let's go ahead and get started on the showcase. Okay, it is daytime now, and let's go ahead and get started on the showcase. So here is the walk. We have the run. Next we have sitting. They look so cute when they sit. Next we have sleeping. Next we have, was it aggro? Then we have cower. Okay, so it is winter, but I just recently figured out I'd never paid attention to this button right here, but I could have clicked that so that you guys could actually hear the noise. So let's do this again so you guys can actually hear the noises properly. So I mean, you don't know that that happened, but it happened. So now that I've discovered the volume button, let's go ahead and do the noises. So broadcast. Friendly. Aggro. And voice. Okay, so here you are with the voices, and now you're gonna watch the rest of the video, so enjoy. Okay, those are honestly some very intimidating sounds. Then we have their little dirt wiggle. And then we'll do swim, but we'll wait until it becomes daytime to do the swim, so yeah, we'll wait. Oh yeah, I wanted to be sure to show you guys how they eat, so here's when they're eating food. And let's go get some agua. Not sure if it's different on the between they look when they eat and drink, so drink. Oh no, yeah, it's different. Just going, yeah, it's different. So like when they drink. Huh. Just want to add that in there. Not like I have to, but I wanted to. Now it is time for the swim test. So let's just go ahead and show you guys how they look when they swim. Again, this is a grounded creature, so don't go around thinking that you can get away from something in the water if you swim. So this is what its little feet sees. You know, I could just honestly just have them sit here and you guys can see what their feet look like. We'll do that more often. Look at the little feetsies. Look at this big thing just... Let me go out more. Splash, splash. She's so cute. That's so adorable. Definitely wouldn't want this creature. You know, I would like this creature. Almost all these creatures, I would like for them to guard my house. If something, you know, like if I'm being robbed or something. Because no one would come near the house with something that looks like this. Look at the little feetsies. I can't help it. So cute. But that is what they look like when they're in the water swimming. But again, don't think you can outrun have semi-aquatic creatures with your grounded creature. It is not going to happen. I think that is everything for this video. If you guys enjoyed it, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, And also click the notification bell so you can get more information and dings whenever we have more videos that come out. I hope you have a great day or night, and I will see you in the next video. Laters!